Hello everybody, in this video we're going to learn about solving multiplication and division equations. I'm going to start with a little visual here. Let's say $4 can buy you 8 bananas. So we have a little equation here of $4 equals 8 bananas. If we divide by 4, we can figure out what each dollar will get us in terms of bananas. So I divided those $4 into four things, and I'm going to divide these bananas into four groups as well. And you can see that one of these dollars is equivalent to two bananas. So we could put a little equal sign in there. $1 equals two bananas if $4 equals eight bananas. We're going to give you that same equation but using algebra tiles. So in this case, instead of dollars, we have x's, and instead of bananas, we have 1's, which would add up to 8. And we could see the same thing is going to happen. If I divide these x's into 4 groups, and I divide these 1's into 4 groups, we can see that an x is equivalent to, and I keep spinning them, is equivalent to 2 1's, or we could call that 2. So x equals 2. Now those are kind of visual representations of what's going to go on, but how are we going to see this most often written in our work or in the future? In the future it'll look like this, 4x equals 8. And you can see that that's what we started with, right? 4x equals 8 ones. So 4x equals 8. And to solve that, we can use the division property of equality and divide by 4 on both sides, which is what we did visually. So if we divide both sides by 4, what happens is we get x, because 4x's divided into 4 groups becomes 1x, and then 8 divided by 4 we know is 2. And we can check that. We can say, see that 4 times 2 equals 8. So this is just the check that our actual answer is right here. Let's move on and try another. So here's another equation, 3x equals 15. And we're going to use the division property of equality because since there's x is being multiplied by 3, we can counteract that by dividing by 3. And of course, the division property of equality states that we have to do the same thing to both sides of the equation. And so we're going to get x, because 3 divided by 3 is 1, right? So 1x is equal to 5. And we can check our answer. 3 times 5 equals 15. That's true. And let's do another one. In this case, we have the variable on the other side, but it will be done the same way. We follow the variable. So the variable is m. It is being multiplied by 6. So we can use the inverse operation. Inverse of multiplication is going to be division. So we're going to divide by 6. And that cancels that out, leaving us with m over here. And 24 divided by 6 is 4. Again, we can check that by going back to the original equation. 6 times 4, this is true, so this is the correct answer, and that was the correct answer there. Alright, let's take a look at this one. Pretty similar. We have the x here being multiplied by 10. We can use the division property of equality. Divide both sides by 10. In this case, the 10s get reduced or canceled out, leaving us with an x on the left. And in this case, we actually don't end up with a whole number because a 5 is not divisible by 10. But what we can do is take this fraction here, which is 5 tenths, and reduce it to 1 over 2. So this is going to be our final answer, x equals 1 over 2. And we can check that logically, actually, or with mathematics. So 10 over 1 times 1 half, or half of 10, is equal to 5. And we know that to be true. So we know 1 half is the correct answer. Now, similar to the division property of equality, we can solve a division, an equation that involves division with multiplication. And so if we have x divided by 3 equals 7, to counteract division by 3, we can multiply by 3. So I'm just going to write this down here again, x divided by 3. And I'm going to say, well, I'm going to multiply by 3. It's going to equal 7 multiplied by 3. And so the division by 3 and the multiplication by 3 cancel each other out, so we end up with x equals 21. So that's our answer, and we can check that by going back to the original equation and plugging in this 21 here. 21 divided by 3 equals 7. Yep, I agree. All right, let's try it over here with y divided by 12 equals 4. So we can multiply both sides by 12, because since the variable is being divided by 12, we can multiply by 12 to counteract that. And so that leaves us with y on the left side, and then 4 times 12 is 48. So we think this is the answer, and we're going to double check that. Plug it back into the original. 48 divided by 12 equals 4. So y equals 48 was correct. Now, sometimes we get decimals as well, but we can still answer it the same way. So x is being divided by 2.3, so we can use the multiplication property of equality to get rid of that division. And so we're left with x on the left side, and whatever 6 times 2.3 is, I think it's 12, 13.8, I believe that is the answer. Now to check it, we can just say 13.8, or 138 is divided by 23. And does it go in 6 times? I'm not sure. Let's see. Times 10 would be 230, so half of that would be 115. Yeah, I think that works. 23 times 6. 18. Yep. Okay, so that works, because 138 divided by 23, or 13.8 divided by 2.3, equals 6. So our answer was correct. Now you notice we have this x here, which represents a variable. But then I drew an x here to represent multiplication, which can be very confusing. So most often, rather than having a division symbol like that and a multiplication symbol like that, this problem would actually look like this. So in the future, you're more likely to see the problem look like this. And it means the same thing. Remember, a division bar is the same thing as a division symbol, or a fraction bar is the same thing as a division symbol. And so we can show multiplication by using a parenthesis. So we could say 2.3. We're multiplying both sides by the same thing, and that allows us to cancel out the 2.3, leaving us with x equals, again, 13.8. It's the same problem we did before. It's just written in a different format. And this is the common format that you're going to see in the future. So we need to get used to that. And that's it for today's video. Thanks for watching.